Yeah. you very much. That was Fables of Phorbas by Charles Mingus. And it's a song about the Governor Phorbas, who called in the National Guard in order to try and prevent black children going to the Central High School in Little Rock. There are some words to it, which we didn't produce tonight. In fact, when Mingus first recorded it on Mingus' album, Columbia refused to let him use the words, and it had to wait until the recording on Candid, great record called Mingus Presents Mingus, where he sang the words with Danny Richmond, the drummer. We're moving on to a piece now arranged by Kate Williams, and it's by Victor Jara, and it's called Caminando.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I think this is a good time to introduce the band, to let you know who you're listening to. This is the second gig in a series presented by the Musicians Collective Way Out West as part of the EFG London Jazz Festival. And as you have gathered, we are playing live to you from the lovely venue, which is Riverhouse Barns in Walton on Thames, because otherwise we could be anywhere, couldn't we? So you are listening to Tony Kofi on alto and baritone sax, and Chris Biscoe, who's kind of my co-presenter for tonight. It's like doing like a morning breakfast show or something with Kate and Chris. Chris Biscoe on lots of different saxes, rather than me having to say them all. And Pete Hurt on tenor, and you also heard him on flute on that last tune. And we have two special guests, also the wonderful John Scott on the drums, and the equally wonderful Connor Chaplin over there on the double bass. So we're going to continue now. I'm going to announce the next two tunes, actually, so that so I'm not jumping up and down like a yo-yo. The next one is another tune by Charles Mingus, and it's called Oh Lord, Please Don't Let Them Drop That Atomic Bomb on Me. It's a very long title. And we're going to then close this set with an arrangement of mine of a very old tune from the 1930s entitled Brother, Can You Spare a Dime? And then after that, there's going to be a short interval feature, which is, you will see it on your screen, which is a rather summery, lovely, optimistic video made by our fellow Way Out Wester vocalist, Emily Saunders. We thought that it should cheer everyone up in these sort of cold autumnal days. So anyway, now we're going to play tune by Mingus, Oh Lord, Please Don't Let Them Drop That Atomic Bomb on Me, followed by Brother, Can You Spare a Dime?
Thank you. Thank you.
the interval. We'll be back in about 10 minutes, but first, please watch and enjoy Emily Saunders' video. wait for John? To make a grand entrance. Ooh. John Scott making his presence felt. John Scott on the drums. Oh, applause. Thank you. Don't forget to turn your phones down. Tony Kofi on the alto and baritone saxophone. Pete Hurt on tenor sax and flute. Connor Chaplin on bass and Kate Williams on the piano. We're performing for you from the Riverhouse barn in Walton on Thames, and we're very, very pleased to be here because people have been most friendly and helpful and have enabled us to play where most people are not able to play at the moment. And it happens that in Walton on Thames, just up the road from here, there was in 1650. A group called the Levellers, or the Diggers, which was sort of proto-anarchist, communist commune of some sort, of agrarian commune, had their first commune on St. George's Hill. And Leon Rosselson wrote a song about this, about how they set up the commune, and then how it was not very long later, 20 days or something afterwards, it was broken up. And the tune is called The World Turned Upside Down. And in the middle, we're going to play something I wrote called On St. George's Hill. And then we return to Leon Rosselson's song. And I'm going to attempt to get something musical out of this very small misery stick. Thank you.
Thank you.
So I better do another announcement. Yeah. Thank you. World Turned Upside Down by Leon Rosselson. And we're going to play now a piece by Mike Westbrook, which is an arrangement, not an arrangement, it's a composition, I should say, called Let the Slave. And it's based on, in fact, the original is based on two poems of William Blake's. And you can find great versions of it on YouTube and so on Mike Westbrook's own moving picture show with a fantastic singer, Phil Minton, singing the song. But Mike has made done a special arrangement for this lineup for three saxophones and piano, bass and drums of Let the Slave.
Mm-hmm.
thank you very much. We're coming to our final two tunes. I'm going to announce them both together, but there'll be a little gap in between. So the next one that we're going to play is actually we're going to do as a quartet, and we're going to feature Chris Biscoe on alto. This is a tune that I discovered very recently, just in the course of chatting to Chris about this gig and putting the programme together. This is like within the last week. Chris mentioned this tune. We were trying to think of things which would fit with the theme of songs of protest. So this is actually called Mendacity. Quite topical, maybe. And it was actually written by Abby Lincoln and Max Roach. And I found a recording of it and listened to it. It's about voting rights in the US. So just pretty relevant, I think. Anyway, I did a very quick arrangement of it like a couple of days ago for this. So I'm going to do that. It's a ballad called Mendacity. And then we're going to finish our set and the gig with a tune by the legendary Joni Mitchell called Big Yellow Taxi. So Mendacity and then Big Yellow Taxi, which will feature everyone.
Thank you.
Tony Kofi on baritone and alto sax. John Scott on the drums. Connor Chaplin on the double bass. Pete Hurt on tenor, and earlier on you heard him on flute. And special thanks to Chris Biscoe, who's sort of been my part. We've sort of organised the set together between us, and it's always a pleasure to work with Chris. He's a brilliant musician, and it's just great to work with him. So Chris Biscoe on assorted saxophones there. And I'd also like to... I'd like to thank Emily Saunders for providing the video for our wonderful sunny interval feature. And I'd also like to really shout out a massive thanks to everyone at Riverhouse Barn, because it's really not easy putting things on in this climate. It's been very trying, I think, for all of us musicians and for venues alike, just for the arts in general. And so to be able to come to somewhere like this and be able to perform live with such wonderful, helpful people who do everything to make things happen and allow us to continue to perform in some way, albeit not with a live audience, but we hope that will happen, you know, before too long when it's safe to do so. So big thanks to Riverhouse Barn. Long may this venue continue. And thank you all very, very much for watching. If you want to know about future gigs that Way Out West has coming up, you can look at our website, which is wowjazz.org, I think. But if you Google Way Out West Jazz, you'll find us. So we hope to see you before very long. Stay safe, and we'll see you next time. Good night.
Great. Great. Yeah.